Hey everyone, it's your boy Lynch, back in here, about to do a reaction, or rather talk about a reaction from a year ago. Last year, March 2023, I shot a reaction to Flume's Things Don't Always Go The Way You Plan. But I'm an absolute idiot and forgot to kind of just edit it. I felt very overwhelmed last year. The pressure was really high in my mind. I don't know why. Anyways, I've come to the conclusion that, you know what? That reaction was one of my favorites and I really need to upload it. Problem is, I've lost the first clip. I have no idea at all where the hell it's gone. And I think it's just going to cut into me talking about tracklist in a moment. haven't edited it yet, so we'll see. But I hope you enjoyed this reaction from a year ago. I apologize for the shirt in advance. It really is hideous. I've never liked it. I think I bought it for a night out once at university. God knows. I think it's about to cut in
any second.
This is the one. Now going over the track list here, you can clearly see there's an aesthetic choice that's been made with all the tracks being labeled with their version number and the year of export. And that's kind of cool, you know, because it shows his roots and it connects with like the bedroom producers and the beat makers alike, you know? So I think maybe he did this to show that obviously these songs were never finished at the time that he wanted them to be. And it shows like the time span of when these songs were made and things. I guess it's kind of cool, you know? Before I begin this reaction, please make sure you subscribe to the channel and you're following my Instagram page for more exclusive content. So let's get down to business here. Things Don't Always Go The Way You Plan by Flume. Track 1, Counting Sheep V2 2018 Export WAV featuring Injury Reserve. I don't know much about them, but I'm hoping this is a cool track. Let's do this. Ooh, that is a hard beat. Okay, all right.
Chips on it with your chest out. Yeah, your tall tales are getting fleshed out. All that huffing and puffing your breath out.
Yo!
Lame ass niggas getting pressed now.
Damn!
Did your Googles break your
okay.
Best out? Like huh. Cool. Yeah, seen that shit on TV. Did it when you count the sheep. But it's all the same thing, right? Yeah,
this is a vibe.
Time was gold. They say, hang dry, hair wash. If you can't, nick a lines of gold. But we believe that shit a few lines ago was scissors.
Man, just saying the letter Z and it goes hard. Please, nigga. This is insane. This is not what I was expecting the project to start like. Wow.
Going back, shit we love. Into the tunnel, screaming like they be lying. You doing all this shit for all we lie.
Oh my god.
Plug to pause. This can't be right.
That's a way to start your project. Damn. Track 2. Nice to know you. 1.5.3. 2020 Export WAV, I think. Light melodic Flume synths. I love that. Oh, that's so good. There's something about them. There's like a sense of melancholy in them, but also a sense of hope. It's kind of hard to explain, but yeah, I love this. Build into something. Oh, it is part of the track. Okay. Very glitchy. I love glitchy Flume. Like, I'm a sucker for it. This is amazing. Oh my goodness. Oh yes. Give me those munchy beats. Ooh. This is delectable. Beautiful. Perfect production. Oh my gosh. Producers wish they could make stuff like this. This is insane. Future bass. This is why he's called the king of future bass. This is so sick. The vocal. Ah, yes. Beautiful. Beautiful. Amazing. Gorgeous. I love this. Yeah. Track 3, Y 1.3 2012 Export WAV. Let's go. Again with the hopeful, melancholic synths. It's so good. So I'm guessing this is from like when he made his first album. Damn, that's a long time ago. It's like 11 years old. Okay. Those beautiful, Flumey synths with a little melody in the background. So nice. It's got that hip-hoppy, Flumey sound that we've come to know and love with that house tinge, you know? It's hard to think this is from over a decade ago, and this was made around the time that he made his debut LP, Flume. I'll be definitely testing this in my car, because this is perfect for a late evening drive, you know? February's been down. Track 4, Rhinestone 1.7.2, 2018 Export WAV, featuring Isabella Manfredi. Oh, those drums so tight! Oh! And that vocal processing, God! Imagine getting a female singer on your track and then just pitching them all the way down, like, what? I'm in love, I love it, oh my gosh. Essential Flume pop, you know, it's actually really nice. Kind of hard to believe he didn't put this out before until now. I love the contrast between the first half of this song and the second half, where her voice is now normal pitch. I love it. It's great. Now we're in the midway point. Track 5, Dream 1.2.2, 2016 Export WAV. His production is just so clean and unique. I know this is common knowledge by now, but his production is just so unique and clean. I'ma shut up. That bass just hit my soul. I'm loving all the multiple rhythms on the melody. Like, it's so cool. The way he treats a vocal is just so beautiful and weird and, like, completely unorthodox. To think he left this off Skin, man. To think he didn't even put this out with the Skin Companions EP. Wow. This has just been sitting with his drive for like 6 years. Damn. I tip my hat to you, Harley. This is beautiful. Wow. Track 6, Beat 58.1.1, 2020 Export WAV. What is this? Ah! Yes, 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 yes. Oh. The ambient synth sprinkled in the background. Ah! The production nerd inside me is having an orgasm right now. Oh my god. Too good! How is anyone supposed to compete with this? Oh my god. How is anybody supposed to sit down as a musician and go, I'm gonna make music today and it's gonna sound as good as Flume when it sounds that good? Track 7, Close 1.2, 2016 Export WAV. It sounds a little similar to Dream. It's quite cool though. I love how his tracks just set an atmosphere, and like, as soon as you're sucked into the atmosphere, then it evolves and it takes you somewhere else, and you're just like hopping dimensions basically in his music, you know? That bass, the vocal chants, the beautiful ambient plush Flume melody in the background. Ambient future bass, wasn't expecting that. This is like the second track in this style. I'm not sure which one I prefer, but I absolutely love this. This is something to watch a sunset to. Preferably in Australia, not that I've ever been there, but presumably that's probably where it works best, right? Just phenomenal. Just phenomenal. I really don't have any other words for this. This is just wow, you know, really, truly wow. Yeah. Track 8, One Step Closer 1.4 2021 Export WAV featuring Panda Bear. This actually sounds like another song that I know, but I can't think what it is right now. There's some rumblings going in this track that just sounds so bassy and deep. This is so different for Flume, you know? It's just a piano, very light synthesis in the background, and a vocal, you know? Track 9, Spoke to Aliens Finally 1.3 2020 Export WAV. Yeah, off the bat, it literally sounds like aliens communicating, doesn't it? Let's be real. The way Flume processes vocals is just unmatched. It's just so good. And I wouldn't want to ever like try and recreate that sound that he does, because it's so uniquely him that it would sound like a ripoff. Do you know what I mean? But it's fascinating to hear someone do this with their vocals. It's so good. I love it. But you can instantly tell it's a Flume track off the bat. Off the bat. Not many producers have such a distinctive sound in this day and age, so it's kind of cool to hear that someone still does, you know? Ooh. Right? Sounds like garage almost, like it's like garage rhythm. The way the bass slides into the drop, I love that, that's so cool. The way this track explodes into like a nice sort of cascade of euphoria, it's great, you know? This genuinely does sort of feel like an abduction, like you're slowly being abducted by an alien, and like as the song progresses you're like almost getting to grips with the confirmation that aliens exist, you know? I like it. I really like this track. It's a cool concept, and yeah. Track 10, Things Don't Always Go the Way You Plan 1.2 2020 Export WAV. Oh, hey, what is that bass? That bass sounds like something out of a Deadmau5 tune. Oh. We're in for a ride, aren't we? Oh, wow! I was not expecting that! The synths keep, like, evolving and devolving, and the drums keep changing underneath. If I didn't know any better, I'd assume this is a Deadmau5 collab. Like, this is crazy. There's a lot going on in this track. For Flume, it probably isn't enough. I love it though. And I'm glad this exists. I'm glad this is out. That bass hits so hard. Verdict time. Okay, so that was Things Don't Always Go the Way You Plan. I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10. The only reason I'm giving it an 8 out of 10 is there's a couple tracks I wasn't too sure on. Not that they were bad, it was just in terms of the flow and the way it sort of went from one another. But I really enjoyed everything I heard on this project, and I feel like it's gonna definitely grow into a 9. Like, I really, really, really enjoyed it. Is it better than Hiatus's Flume? No, but then what is, you know? What I find really interesting about this is obviously you can see the years of when these tracks were made, and you can sort of imagine and kind of put together when and where they were gonna be put project-wise. There's a lot of ideas here that, you know, really come together well in a cohesive little project like this. Hoping there are more projects.
And there were.
Really hoping the next one has Spook.
It didn't.
For the love of God, Harley, if you're watching this, please put Spook on one of these projects. Or just release it as a digital single, you know? I'm happy with the MP3, sure, but you know, some people want this on their Spotify. I don't use Spotify. I want this thing in WAV. I want this thing in high quality, man. It's such a classic track. It's a beautiful song, and it deserves love, and it deserves to have a home or a project or something. Anyways, that was my reaction to the new Flume mixtape, guys. Let me know what you think, and take care.